We're gonna fire up the old Louisville today in the Ford Cargo because I'm gonna pull the float out and put the new rims and tyres on it, because we've potentially got someone that might be interested in buying it. And I wasn't gonna sell it, but I thought about it, and there's, for the stuff I wanna do, recovering stuff that's not running and or inoperable, there's probably better options out there, like with a fold down neck maybe and a winch or a tilt and slide. So if I sell this and break even, then I can put that money into the S2 or another trailer that might be a bit more suitable for dragging stuff on and stuff that doesn't run. So I'm going to start the Louisville first and then the Cargo, and pull it out of the way and pull it over to the shed and start bolting tyres on. I've fitted all but two because there's two rims sitting on there I need to undo. And then, yeah, we'll bolt them on and can see these two things run and go from there. Runs well. But annoying noise. So that thing won't go, it's too many flat batteries and I'd have to charge them up or something. They're just sucking the juice out of the good batteries, so that can stay there and we'll do a 3-point turn. I've got a dodgy battery in there and then we'll jump onto that. I just gotta find where the priming pump is and give it a few primes, wherever it is, somewhere up there. It'd be staring me in the face. Ah, there. Yeah, this side, yeah. Got another dodgy battery in there because jumper leads weren't any good. Hang on. I'll give it another pump. I just got to go. I can hear the water in the exhaust. No, it's not. Try again. Water-cooled exhaust, as you can see. the cab down. Yeah. here, so I'm just trying to get the brakes to free up. They're locked on, obviously. Noticed already, I'm sitting on the left hand side, which is normal for America obviously, but in Australia we're on the right hand side, and as you can see there, it's got two steering wheels. So from new, this was a street sweeper, so you could sit either side to sweep the gutters on the road and watch the gutter brush in the mirror. So that's probably why I'm struggling a bit here, because it's just a bit different when you're in the left hand side trying to reverse, along with having no mirror on the door. It's just a bit different sitting on the opposite side.
Good. I like it.
So I fitted all the tyres to the rims apart from two, because they were bolted to that hub, so I unbolted them. Got four on the back. I'm just going to start the big Toyota forklift to lift the float up, save jacking it up. So that's as far as I got yesterday, because we went and looked at another project which I ended up buying. That'll probably make a YouTube video as well soon. So that'll be alright to watch. It's coming down on a tilt tray tomorrow. So this video will go up before that gets here, but I'll make a video on its own. There's the latest project that I bought the other day when I said I was going to have a look at something. So there it is. It's a Cat 226B full air cab, just missing the front door. I think it's done the hydraulic coupling. It's just a plastic coupling because the pump's loose, the bolts. So I think they've come loose while it's been running. And so we're just fitting the tyres and see what it looks like, and we'll see if old mate wants to go ahead and buy it. We're fitting them all by hand with a bar, so, but getting pretty quick at it now. I'll do a time lapse of the last two so you can watch me struggle, and we'll go from there. Okay, last two are pumped up. About the 11th one, I get the hang of it. So, but they're on, so it's all right. Now, I'm just thinking, I guess I can jack that front axle up. Dad was gonna lift it up with a forklift, but I might just jack it up, put the wheels on the front axle, and then do the middle. All right, I'll set this up and then I will jack front axle up. Looks like we're going the forklift. Got to give it a fair bit of heat to get it to go easy. Must be a bit heavy. So that means it weighs over 7 ton because the back wheels are off the ground. I don't think it'll lift it all the way somehow. I'm just trying to get them even here. Normally you do them up in a crisscross pattern sort of thing and then give the tyre a bit of spin with a can or something up against it to make sure it's running reasonably true, then go around and tighten them all up, spin it again. If it's still all good, then that'll run true and won't wobble around. all the tyres and wheels are on. It actually looks pretty good now. It actually looks like it can be used, so it's all parked up. It can sit here until hopefully he buys it in a week or two's time. So it'll sit here and I'll have to pull the dolly out from under the screen and put this Ford cargo under. And then, yeah, can move on, put money into the S2 and get another trailer in the future, hopefully. So there's plenty of big spiders. I don't do spiders, so they can stay here. Yuck. All right, that's about it. Thanks for watching. And see you when there's something else exciting going on.
Something else slightly exciting. Yeah, we were just using the John Deere 2010 to go over to that Louisville that we couldn't jump start earlier, and just skull dragging it over to the shed to put the batteries on charge. You'll hear a bit of a noise in a minute. And I thought it was the engine grenading itself, but it just turns out it was the radiator fan hitting on the muffler. So that all turned out to be alright. We straightened the blade and it was fine, but we cut the video off pretty short because I was about to be depressed because I thought it went bang, but you'll hear that in a minute.
Backward.
pretty much where the video ends. It's just more of a bunch of videos put together of what I was sort of doing over an hour or two each day during the week when I had a spare bit of time, just getting a few jobs ticked off the list that needed to be done. There'll be probably video soon on the cat skid steer, so we'll get onto that. I'm gonna pull the pump off and check it is that drive coupling between the motor and the pump, and we'll go from there with that. There's another truck coming that'll be in another video soon when that gets delivered. I've looked at it and paid for it, so that'll be in another video. We've got a bit of stuff going on and just ordering bits flat out for the S2, so hopefully everything gets here and then we can just start on it and don't have to stop and wait for too many parts. So appreciate watching, hit the like button and subscribe, it always helps and keeps me motivated. So yeah, cheers for watching and we'll see you on the next one.